Hi, Professor Vishal Taylor. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I teach you Francis Turbines, its introduction, its various component and its working. So first, we understand the introduction of the Francis Turbine. Here you see the image of Francis Turbines that we discuss later on. So first, we study the introduction. Francis Turbine is a reaction turbine. It was designed by an American engineer, J.B. Francis. Now, first we writing the 5 points related to Francis Turbine when it is asked in exam. So, this 5 point is written for any turbine from the classifications. Okay, so if you know the classification, then you can able to write down 5 points. So, if this question is come in examination, so you can easily write down these 5 points. Okay, and if you don't know the classification, then go on to I symbol on the top right screen of your mobiles, or also go in description or a playlist to watch the more video. So first point is that it is a reaction turbine. Okay, not reaction flow, but it is a reaction turbine. Reaction means kinetic energy and pressure energy at enters to the turbine. Here you see that is the water is inlet in this turbine. So water inlet have two types of energy. One is kinetic and second one is the pressure energy. Second point is that it is a mixed flow turbine. Mixed flow means water enters radially and leave axially. So here it is the runners. On the runner, water is enter in this runner in a radial direction, and water come in the axis parallel to this shaft. So in vertical direction, water is coming out from this part. So it is known as the leave axially. So it is clearly explained in these classifications. So if you know classification, then you can understand it easily. Third point is that in a Francis turbine, it's a use for a medium head. Fourth point is that it is in medium quantity of the waters. And fifth point is that it is a medium specific space. So for a Francis turbine, it is too easy to understand it, because in a out of 5 points, 4 point is start with the M. So you can easily write that is mixed flow, medium head, medium quantity, everything is to the medium. So you can easily it's remember for the examinations. Subscribe these channels for watching this more video and press the bell icon for getting continuous update. Next, we understand the various component of the Francis turbine. So component of Francis turbine, before that I see you this image. So this upper part is a front view of the Francis turbine, and this is a top view of the Francis turbine. So when you see the Francis turbine from the top, it is look like as the circular portions. Okay. So in a Francis turbine, there is a various component. So first here we know the name of the component, then we go into the detail. First is the penstock. Okay, so penstock is not showing in this image, but here the water inlet. Okay, so water is come from this penstock. Second part is the spiral gassing. Means this part in a top view is known as the spiral gassing that we run in detail. And in front view, this part is known as the spiral gassing. Third is the guide blade. So in a front view, this is guide band on the both side because it is circular component, and in the top view, this part is known as the guide band. Then after, fourth part is runner. So runner is mounted on the shaft. So this is the main shaft, and this part is known as the runner. In a top view, this part is known as the runner. And the fifth component, it is the draft tube. So this part is known as the draft tube. So one by one, we understand this component in the details. Before that, I request to like the video and comment on the video. So first is the penstock. What is the penstock? Penstock is a large diameter conduit which carry water from dam or a reservoir to the turbine house. Means it supplied the water from a dam to the turbine inlet, means up to this part. Then after turbine is start. Francis turbines require a larger volume of waters than the Pelton wheel turbine. And generally the penstocks are made of a steels and the concrete, that is depending upon the quantity of waters and the availability of the head. And thrust rake are provided at the inlet of the penstock to ensure that no debris and another foreign matters enters into the penstocks. Okay. Next component, it is a spiral gassing. So its name suggests that the casing have a shape of the spiral. Before that, I explain you casing. Casing means it is the outer part of the any component. It is known as the casing. Okay. So this is the outer part of this turbine. It's known as casing in top view. This part in the top front view is type of the casing. Spiral means the casing have a maximum area at the inlet. Means this part is known as the inlet of the casing, and these are the outlet. So it is a gradually increasing area. Means here the maximum area, when we going further, its area or the volume is continuously reducing. Okay, that is known as the spiral casing. Spiral casing have a maximum area at entrance and a nearly zero at the tip. Area of the spiral casing increase uniformly along the circumference. Means we moving ahead, the area of the casing is reduced. The water from the penstock through the guide vents uniformly distributed over the runner vents. Means the Q quantity of water is coming, it is uniformly supplied the water into these different vents. Means water is entered from this part, water is entered from this part, it is also entered from this part. So it is uniformly circulate the quantity of water, that I show you the another image for that understanding. Hence quantity of water flowing to the spiral casing uniformly increase. Means quantity of water is increase. Why increase? Because the water is inlet is here. So some water is supplying from this part, some water is supplied from this part, some water is supplied from this part. So it is continuously supplying from the different guide vents. So quantity of water is reduced when it is reached up to the end. Okay. And the velocity of the waters will be constant. Okay. So why this velocity is remains constant? So if we think that the area of the casing is reduced continuously, then velocity is remains to increase. But in this case, velocity is remains constant because quantity Q is not remains constant, because quantity is continuously reduced when the water is moving ahead. Okay. Because some is supplying in the different guide vents. Okay. That's why the quantity is reduced. Area is also reduced. That's why velocity is remains constant in a spiral casing. So here I show you this image. This is the inlet of the casing. Water is enters. Area is gradually increasing, and this way water is tried to supplying in the different guide vents. That's why quantity is continuously reduced. And area is reduced, that's why velocity is remains constant throughout this casing. If you learned, then like the video, subscribe the channels and share with your friend. These are the another image of the casing for the clear reason purpose. So here you can see the area is larger, ahead moving area is reduced, this part is soft. Next we understand the component guide vents. So what is a guide vent? From this name we can understand, guide means it's guide the flow of the water. Simple. Guiding means help to others. So this guide blade is help the water to enter in a proper direction to the runner. It is known as the guide blade. And its shape is aerofoil shape. So in this image, here we can understand this part is guide vents. Okay. So here this is different guide vents. That is a number of guide vents. So here two guide vents is indicated, one is by continuous line and another one is the dotted line. That I understand. Later on, first we understand its basic. They are a fix between the two rings in a form of fill. Means guide blade is fixed on a two ring. So this is one ring, that is the outer ring, and this is the inner ring. On the support of these two ring, the guide vents are fixed. This pivot point is on the centers or either in a outer part. So it is pivoted. So it can just swing about these pivot points. Okay. So support is pivot point is on the center. Okay. So from the center point, the van is moving at a different angle like that dotted lines. Okay. So when it is in this part, means continuous line, the area between the two van is higher, means more area to flow, then the more quantity of water is supplied. Now suppose if we are required to reduce the quantity of water supplied to the turbine, then what we doing? We are moving the guide vents, and guide vent is come into these new positions like as these dotted lines. At that time what happened? The area between the two guide vents are reduced. Means less area of flow. Less area of flow means quantity of water is reduced, because water is entered at the continuous velocity in these different vents. So the water quantity passing through the guide blades are depends on the position of guide blade, that we understand the different two positions. But there is a number of positions are possible for a guide vents. And the guide blades are generally made of the castings. Next we understand the runner. It is the most important component of a Francis turbine. So here you see the image of the runners. So we understand the runner points. So runner have a number of fans. Okay. So in this image, if you count, then it is a 16 to 24 number of fans. So minimum is 16 and up to 24 van is used for the runners. So it is a two types of van. One in van is in the guide vans, which have a aerofoil shape, and another vans in a runner. So waters with high kinetic and pressure energy float through the runners and mark a runners to rotate and generate the power. So water coming out from these guide vans is enter radial directions in a runners, and the water energy is supplied to the runners and runner is start to rotate. Means water energy or hydraulic energy is converted into the mechanical energy into the runner and runner is start to rotate. Mechanical energy of this runner is supplied to the generators by using this mains arm, and the generator is produced the electricity and then after it is supplied to our homes for a use. In a Francis turbines runner, the flow of water is combination of radial and axial. Means it is radially in and axially out in a modern Francis turbine. But in old Francis turbines, water inlet and outlet both are in the radial directions. Okay, but recently that majority of the mixed flow turbine is used. Enters radially, inwards and leaves in directions parallel to axis of the rotor that we already discussed. And the number of runner vans are 16 to 24 for the Francis turbines. If you learned and like the video, subscribe the channel with your friend and share with your friend. And last part is the draft tube. So draft tube is installed at the outlet of the turbine. And the draft tube is a pipe of gradually increasing area which connect the outlet of the runner to the tail rest. Means this is the outlet of the turbine runners. Okay, so here we install the draft tube, and draft tube is a gradually increasing area. If you want to learn the detail in the draft tubes, then the link is provided on the top right screen from the eye symbols, and also link is provided in the descriptions. And you can also go to the watch list for watching this different video of the different subject. It is used for discharging the waters from the axis of the turbines to the tail rays, and this pipe of gradually increasing area is called as the draft tubes. Thank you for watching this video. If you learned and like the video, subscribe the channels and share with your friends.